The Dow is over 22,000, but the Nasdaq is losing steam. Eric Wiegand of U.S. Bank, do the Nasdaq's declines throw cold water on the Dow's milestone?
Well, I think it's more illustrative of, you know, what the broader markets are doing. It has been a healthy and a robust advance on a year-to-date basis. You know, the interesting thing about the Dow is it's price-weighted, not market cap-weighted. So you have a disproportionate impact from some of the higher price shares, which just so happen to have been, you know, much more, had more favorable performance on a year-to-date basis.
Where do you see the Dow headed by year's end?
You know, for us, again, the preference is for, you know, looking at broader indices. As far as broader indices are concerned, things like the S&P 500, we do think that they end marginally higher.
We're now at 2477.
Correct, which is, you know, which has pretty much been where our year-end target has been. The reason why we think we have the likelihood of drifting higher towards year-end is just the strength of earnings. We think that earnings are really what is the primary determinant of valuations right now.
But does it worry you that the leaders of the Dow, like Boeing, get most of their revenue from overseas?
Well, it's actually been supportive seeing some of the weakness in the dollar. So we would expect that to provide a tailwind, you know, to those companies that have, you know, broader international operations. We would have concern, though, if we do see rising levels of concern around trade issues emanating from Washington. Mm.
But the Russell 2000, which is more of a U.S.-centric gauge, that's only up 4% so far this year. So how do you grapple that with the rise in some of the broader industries?
Yeah, you know, from our perspective, it really reflects the economic reality. We've seen firming growth internationally among our global trading partners. That is reflective of more of the global businesses. The Russell, as you mentioned, 2000, has more U.S.-centric in that we've seen just some moderation, some middling-type economic activity domestically.
And opportunities you see in the coming months?
From our perspective, we do think that there's a likelihood that there will be increased volatility as we move through August into early September, some of the normal seasonality, but also reflecting we've had a rather wonderful start to our second quarter earnings season. It's coming to conclusion. We don't have a Fed meeting in August, and all investor attention will certainly turn to fiscal policy and the prospects of a growth agenda being achieved. So could see some choppiness in the near-term opportunities. We still remain biased towards equities, both U.S. as well as developed international.
All right, Eric Wiegand, we'll leave it there. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.